Hello all, my name is Krishnayaka, welcome to my YouTube channel. So guys, from past many days, many people are talking about XGBoost. It was one of the most requested video by you all. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about XGBoost classifier. And in the upcoming videos also, I'll be discussing about XGBoost regression. I have been uploading a lot of practical implementation with respect to XGBoost. So please make sure that you focus on this session. And yes, we will be following step by step. This probably will be a 20 minutes video, 20 to 25 minutes video. I'll try to keep it as short as possible and I'll try to explain you all the things. Now, they are in the ensemble techniques, you basically have two different kinds, right? One is the bagging, one is the boosting, right? And XGBoost, AdaBoost, gradient boosting, those are kind of boosting algorithms, you know? And when we consider random forest classifier, that is actually a bagging classifier itself, right? So in random forest classifier, you'll be able to see that we will be constructing decision tree parallelly and we'll be taking the data and we'll be training our model. Whereas in sequential, we'll be creating one decision tree and after that, we'll capture the residuals from them and we'll similarly construct decision tree. If you have not seen my gradient boosting, guys, and again, you need to know gradient boosting algorithm if you want to really understand how does extreme gradient boosting actually work. So XG, right? The full form is extreme gradient. So let's go ahead and try to understand how does XGBoost classifier gets trained. And we'll try to discuss a whole lot in complete depth. So let me take a very good example, a simple example. So on the first feature, you have salary, right? On the second feature, you have credit score. On the third feature, you basically have approval. So based on your salary and credit score, whether the bank is going to give you a loan or not, or whether a bank is going to give you a credit card or not. Okay, this is the way that I have taken a very simple example. Now, I have data set like less than or equal to 50K. The credit score is bad. I have classified credit score in three categories. Bad, good, normal. Okay, bad, good, normal. Okay, and the output is either 0 and 1 since we are solving a classification problem. And again, XGBoost is also useful in solving multi-class classification problem also. So let's go ahead. Now in the first step, here I've actually written some of the steps over here. So first of all, we will be constructing a base model. Okay, this base model is pretty much important. And how we will be constructing a base model, what will be the output of the base model? Since this is a classification problem, right? Your output is either 0 and 1. So what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to take the average of this like 0 plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, because there are only two outputs. So by default, my probability will be 0.5. Okay, so I have taken this, the base model based on probability, the output, I'm not talking about the output of the base model. I'm just talking that the probability initially to calculate the residuals will be 0.5 because the classification problem output is only 0 and 1. Now, once we define probability as 0.5, the next step that we are going to do is that basically calculate the residuals. Now, how does the residual gets calculated? We need to subtract this score, this output score like 0 minus this probability. So in this case, I'll be getting minus 0.5. Because if you remember about XGBoost or gradient boosting also, there also we trained with respect to our input features and with respect to the residuals, right? So 0 minus 0.5 is nothing but minus 0.5. 1 minus 0.5 is nothing but 0.5. 1 minus 0.5 is nothing but 0.5. 0 minus 0.5 is nothing but minus 0.5. So this is pretty much clear. Then again, we have 1 minus 0.5, then again 1 minus 0.5, 0.5, 0 minus 0.5 is minus 0.5. So these are the residuals. Now, once I get the residuals, I will start constructing the tree. Okay. So first tree I will be trying to construct over here. Now, in this example, I'm going to take the column as salary. Okay. How the decision tree will be getting constructed in XGBoost, I'm going to discuss about that. So we'll start constructing the tree. Now, within this particular tree limit, that is on the first node, I have written all the data points over here. Minus 0.5, so you can see minus 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, minus 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 and minus 0.5. So all the data points are over here. Okay. Now, in salary, you have two categories. Okay. In salaries, you have two categories, obviously, right? Less than or equal to 50K, greater than or equal to 50K. Always remember, in XGBoost, whenever you construct a tree, you always need to do a binary classifier. Let it be having three categories also. Let it be having four categories also. So one at once, what you can do is that you create a binary classifier. You basically have to divide in the leaf node will be actually two every time. Okay. So suppose if I have three categories, less than or equal to 50 will go over here. Greater than 50K or greater than 100K, greater than any other value will be going over here. Okay. So at that time you have to do. First of all, we have to do this binary class. We have to do this. We have to basically split this leaf node into two splits, and then we basically need to compute the similarity weight. I'll define about what is this similarity weight. It is pretty much important. And based on the similarity weight, okay, based on the similarity weight, and then we will also find out what is information gain. Okay, if you remember in decision tree, guys, we use entropy, and then we use the information gain to basically do the splitting thing. Okay, now in this particular case, first of all, what we have done, we have split with respect to less than or equal to 50k, greater than 50k, and based on this we have two categories, and you can see that some of the points are here, some of the points are here. How did I come up with these points? Less than or equal to 50k, you can see there is one residual, then you have second residual, minus 0.5, 0.5, then the third one is 0.5, and finally last one is minus 0.5. So you have all the points over here. Now second step is that I will calculate the similarity weight. Okay, how we have to calculate the similarity weight? Understand, summation of all the residuals. So what will be over here? I will try to do the summation. 0.5 plus 0.5 plus 0.5, and this will be minus 0.5 whole square divided by summation of probability, this probability that we have defined initially, multiply by 1 minus probability. Okay, so what we are going to do over here, we are going to take first the probability is nothing but 0.5, 1 minus 0.5, this is for this specific point, then again we will go with the next point, 1 minus 0.5, and this will be based on the total number of residuals that are over here. You have 4 residuals, so we are going to take 4 different probability and we are going to subtract with this. And remember guys, this probability is also going to change later on. Okay, this 0.5 value will be no more when we'll be again calculating the things. Okay, so I have all these values. Okay, now what we do the calculation over here. I will subtract this, I'll subtract this, so this whole value, this whole similarity weight will be zero. So we have computed it over here. You can see that everything is zero. But we'll make this calculation also, this bottom calculation, which is pretty much important. So this will be 0.25 plus 0.25 plus 0.25 plus 0.25. So what is the total sum you have over here? This is 1. Okay, this is 1. So 0 by 1 is nothing but 0. So I have updated the similarity weight as 0. Perfect. Now what we are going to do is that I'm going to remove this. And now I am going to calculate the similarity weight of the second tree that we have, second split that we have done. So in this, the similarity weight will nothing be, it will be the summation of minus 0.5 plus 0.5 plus 0.5 whole square. And then I'm going to use summation of 0.5 minus 1 minus 0.5 plus, see there are 3 residuals. So we are going to do this summation for 3 times. So 0.5 multiplied by 1 minus 0.5 plus 0.5 multiplied by 1 minus 0.5. So these are all your points. Okay. So what we do? We cancel this. Now 0.5's whole square is nothing but 0.25. Okay. And this we know that this is 0.25. This is 0.25. This is 0.25. So this will be nothing but 0.75. Okay. So this is nothing but 1 divided by 3. So 1 by 3 is nothing but 0.33. So here the similarity weight is 0.33. Okay, very much clear. We have computed the similarity weight over here. We have computed the similarity weight. Now, one more similarity weight that we need to compute is basically on the top of this salary, right? We also need to compute this. So here again, we are going to compute the similarity weight. Okay, now here you can see that it is 0.5. This 0.5 will get cancelled. This and this will get cancelled. This and this will get cancelled. So if I do 0.5 whole square, it will be nothing but 0.25 divided by, right? How many times are there? Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 into 0.25, right? 0.25 plus 0.25, right? I hope everybody is getting it. 0.25. So this is 1. Again, we have to add 0.25. So in total, it will be 1.75. Okay? So this will be actually 1.75. Then again, if you do the calculation, how much it is? 25, 5 is 125. 6, 7, right? So this will be nothing but 1 by 7. Okay, 1 by 7 is nothing but if you consider 7 divided by 100, right? So If you write like this, 7 divided by 100, 7 ones are, okay, ones are 7. I'm sorry for doing the calculation in front of you. So it will be somewhere around 0.14. So I'm just going to write it over here. And I've done the computation in front of you with respect to this also. And this is my similarity weight for the root, right? Now, with respect to this, what is the gain that I have to compute? The gain will nothing be. It will be the similarity score in the left hand side, that is 0, plus the similarity score in the right hand side, that is 0.33, minus the similarity score of the root, right? So if I go and subtract 0.14, it will be nothing but 0.21, okay? So 0.21 is my gain. So based on this, the total gain that I get is 0.21. Now, reason I am actually calculating the gain. Understand one thing, guys. Why I am actually calculating gain? Suppose I have one more category over here. Okay, I have one more category. Or why I'm using this specific gain? Because I can start doing the split from credit also, right? From credit feature, from approval feature. Sorry, approval is the output feature. From credit feature also I can start. Now, what I'll do is that the next tree that I'll try to consider will be based on credit. And then I will try to compare the gain by doing the same splitting process. And in this case, you'll be seeing that there are three categories, right? So every time what I have to do, I'll do a binary split. In the first category, I'll say, this is my bad, this is my good and normal. Okay? If this is giving my highest gain, then I'll go with the this split. Understand in that specific way. Okay? Now, this is with respect to gain that we have computed. Now, just consider that my salary was the best way of constructing. The first split that we did was salary, well, the salary feature did well and we got the highest gain. In this, the highest gain was somewhere around 0.22, right? Because I don't want to again compare and credit and basically create it and then again find the gain of credit and then compare it. Just consider that the salary had a better gain when compared to credit. Now from here, I'll be doing the split with respect to credit. Now with respect to credit. Now in credit, you have three categories. So first, I'll make a binary split. Here, I will be putting good and normal. Here, I'll be putting bad. Now with respect to this, how many features you have with respect to bad? Bad is having 0.5 over here. Okay. And anywhere you are having bad with less than or equal to 50. Okay. Less than or equal to 50 also is there. So less than or equal to 50, one bad only is there. Remaining all are good. Right. And good and normal, with respect to less than or equal to 50, how many points we have? So we have 1 point over here, 2 point over here, and 3 point over here. So I'll be saying this one, 0.5, comma 0.5, comma minus 0.5. Now what we'll do, right? Whether I should go with this credit split of blue, green, comma normal in the other split, I mean in the other branch, or can I use blue, comma green in this? That I have to compute in this, right? So again, I'll go and compute the similarity matrix, similarity weight. In this case, when I have just 1 point, that is minus 0.5, right? Minus 0.5. How do I compute it? Again, I'll try to use the summation of residual. Residual is only 1. So this will be nothing but 0.25 divided by 0.5, again, 0.25, right? I hope you know this. Probability is nothing but 0.5, 1 minus 0.5. So 0.5 into 0.5 is 0.25. So this value will get deducted. And here the similarity weight will be equal to 1. Just try to compute it, guys. You will definitely get it 1. Because understand, 0.5. Okay, let me do the calculation over here. Okay. So over here you see that residual square. Only one residual you have. So it will be 0.25. Divided by probability is nothing but 0.5, 1 minus 0.5. Right? This is the probability, right? So here you will be able to see 0.25 divided by 0.25, which will be nothing but 1. So here I am taken the similarity weight as 1. Okay. Now with respect to good and normal, what will happen? I will go and compute 0.5 plus 0.5 is nothing but 1. 1 minus 0.5 is again 0.5. So 0.5 whole square divided by 0.25 plus 0.25 plus 0.25, right? Because I have 3 points, 3 residuals. So in short, this will be nothing but 0.25 divided by 0.75. So this will be nothing but 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is nothing but 0.33. Okay. So again, the similarity weight over here will be 0.33. Now, if I really want to find out the gain, it will be nothing but 1 minus 0.33. Sorry, 1 plus 0.33, that is the left similarity matrix plus right similarity matrix minus the root. Root is nothing but 0. So in this case, I will be getting the gain as 1.33. Right? So here we are having 1.33. So this, the total gain with respect to the split over here is 1.33. But I told you, right? We will not stop here. We will try to compare this same split, something like this. Suppose if I take credit over here, okay? If I take credit over here, and suppose in the left-hand side I put bad and good, in the right-hand side I put normal. Now with respect to this, we'll try to do the split. Okay, we'll try to do the split, right? We'll try to see out of these two, which will be giving the highest information gain, I'll be selecting that split. Understand in that specific way, guys. Whichever will be giving us the highest split, we will be taking that. Okay. And with respect to this, I'm going to write this is 0.33. Okay. This is 0.33. This is the similarity weight, 0.33. Okay. Now, with respect to this, when I do a split on bad and good, right? And remember, this is less than or equal to 50k, because I am doing the split over here. Okay, I can also do the same split over here with respect to credit later on. Okay, now here when I am doing this split again, how many points is basically good and good? 1, 2, 3, right? So good and bad, 1, 2, 3. Then 1, 2, 3 basically means over here is nothing but 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, right? Then if I try to compute the same similarity matrix for this, how much it will be? It will be same, right? Because we got over here same thing. So this will be nothing but 0.33. Again, try to apply this particular formula, you'll get the same value, 0.33. Okay? And here, this is only 1 point. Again, there will be a 1. So if I do this split like this or like this, I'm going to get the same gain. That basically means I can use either one of them. So suppose I go with this part. I go with this part and I create this one. Okay? I create this one. I create this tree. Now, after this, whether we should do the splitting or not, that is actually covered by post-pruning. Post-pruning. Post-pruning is basically calculated in XGBoost by a cover value. What is this cover value? Whatever thing we have actually taken in this denominator. Okay? So, this denominator is nothing but probability of 1 minus prob. So, this will be my cover value. Now, in this case, my cover value is nothing but 0.25. That basically means, if my probability value is 0.25, it's less than 0.25, or if I'm considering that my gain is less than 0.25, I'll just cut the branch. That is called as post pruning. Then you don't have to worry much about it, because this will be the last step altogether. So I'm going to remove this right now. Okay. And here you can actually do the further split with respect to this also. You can take credit over here and you can do this split also, and you can basically construct your decision tree. Okay, but always remember one point, right? Based on your similarity weight and based on your cover pruning, you can cut the tree, you can branch it out, and that is actually called as pre-pruning. Okay, or you can also say it as post-pruning. Okay, because once you construct it and then you cover the you find out the cover value, and based on that you just cut it whenever you find out the value is less than that cover value. Okay, so very important to understand. Now for the new data. Okay, so this is my one decision tree that has got constructed, decision tree 1, right? Like that, I may construct any number of decision tree once I calculate the residuals, okay? Now, with respect to this, whenever I get a new data, suppose I get new data something like this, less than 50k, then the credit is bad. So, less than 50k, the credit is bad, so I'm getting the similarity weight as 1, okay? So, the output of this will be 1, but how do I compute it? So first of all, I really need to find out the base model output with respect to this probability. And to calculate that, I use this formula log of odds. This is just like, probably you have seen this equation also in logistic regression. So here I'm just going to replace p by 0.5. So this will nothing be that log of 0.5 divided by 1 minus p. 1 minus p means 0.5. Then again, you are going to get 0.5. This 0.5 by 0.5 is nothing but 1. Log of 1 is nothing but 0. So this base model will be giving me the output as 0. Right? It will be giving me the output as 0. So once I get the output as 0, if I really wanted to find out what will be the record output or record residual with respect to this, right? Or record probability also with respect to this, what I'll do, I'll just follow this path. Okay, I'll just follow this path. I will be saying that again, I'll apply a sigmoid. First, my base model is giving me the output as 0 plus. Understand how this is getting passed. I'm going to go through this path, less than 50k, then I'm going to this part, then over here with respect to credit I'm getting left and right. But understand, here I'm getting the similarity weight, okay? Because here the credit is bad. In case of bad, I'm getting the similarity rate as 1, right? So I'll take that 1, but before that I will be adding a learning rate. And again, remember guys, this learning rate will be between 0 to 1. Suppose I take this learning rate as 0.1 and I take this value of similarity weight as 1. How much is this value? This is nothing but 0.1. And then I apply my sigmoid activation function or sigmoid function. This sigmoid function is nothing but, if I write it over here, 1 divided by 1 plus e to the power of minus 0.1. So whatever value I get, suppose I get it as 0.6. This 0.6 will be my new probability for this record. Okay, so I'm just going to rub this, guys. Please rewind back if you really want to see it. But just I'm trying to compute the probability. Okay, so here my probability, my new updated probability will be computed. In this case, I got 0.6. Similarly, I'll try to apply this equation every time. Okay, whatever path it is taking, I'm going to construct that specific path. Okay, so suppose here I got it as 0.4. Again, by using this, 0 plus 0.1 into, suppose this second record is basically giving me a similarity weight of 1.33. Then I'll try to multiply this and then I'll try to equate in this particular sigma function, that is my sigmoid function. Suppose I may get 0.4 probability, here I may get 0.3, here I may get 0.7, here I may get 0.2, here I may get 0.1, like this. Now based on this new probability, again I'll try to calculate my residual. How I'll calculate a residual? 0 minus 0.6 is nothing but 0.4, minus 0.4, right? 1 minus 0.6 is 0.6, 1 minus 0.3 is nothing but 0.7. Similarly, this will be 0.0 minus 0.7 is 0.3, this will be 0.8, this will be 0.9, okay? Now based on this new residual, again I will go and compute same decision tree like this till the end, okay? That basically means now I have constructed my first decision tree and this decision tree is giving me this residual. Now again I'll try to construct a new decision tree by taking this independent feature and again I'll be splitting all these particular records. And then I will be able to construct this again. Again I have to use the same formula, but remember, when I'll be computing the new test data, then I have to take this sigma. 0 is basically given by my base model over here. Then I have alpha, which is my learning rate by tree 1. Then again, this will be my alpha by T2. T2 will be this tree, which I'm actually computing for my next residuals, right? So again, I'll try to add like this. Then again, it will be like this, alpha of T3. Like this, we'll try to do till alpha of T of N. And once we apply the sigmoid function, finally, you'll be able to see that my probability will be giving a good value where my residual will be very, very less. At that time, I can consider that XGBoost tree has been trained in a proper way. Okay. One more thing that I missed to tell you is, guys, this about this particular alpha value. Over here, in all the time I have taken, when I'm computing the similarity weight, I have taken alpha is equal to 0. You can always select this alpha value, which is like an hyperparameter. Hyperparameter. Okay. So this is in short how a XGBoost tree actually gets trained. I know it is a little bit cumbersome, but just understand that I've tried to show you so many things in just a board. You can see from here to here completely I've actually written. Just go through the gradient boosting once. If you have not understood, probably just go it once again from the starting. And in the next video, I'll be coming up with regression, that is XGBoost regression trees. Okay. So I hope you like this particular video. Please do share with all your friends. And please do subscribe to the channel if you have not already subscribed. I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day. Thank you, one and all. Bye-bye.